join us on this Target scavenger hunt and giant egg surprise. There's lots of clues. The Hobby family jumped inside the Hobby car and headed to their first stop, the giant surprise egg.
Welcome to the world's biggest, the world's only Target surprise egg.
We're going to get out the first toy, and then you guys are going to come with us to the store on a scavenger hunt. Keep on watching for all the surprises.
Awesome!
Wow, it is the Doomlanders Nerf Lawbringer.
It's an only at Target exclusive toy.
This Nerf blaster shoots 12 darts, and it has a hammer you pull back to let the darts fly. Are you ready to shoot some stuff? Let's do it!
Just kidding. Wow, that is a super awesome Nerf blaster. So show us all the cool stuff this thing's got, man.
So there's a trigger, like on every single one of them. Pulls down. Shoot.
What I like about this thing is it has a clear side so you can see how everything works. Pull this hammer back, there's a spring in the handle that actually will force it to go forward once you pull the trigger. And then when you're pulling the hammer back, it also shows these gears that actually rotate the drum. It's like a real revolver. Fire!
Hey! No! You could also load 12 stars in back. Shooting somebody. When you run out, you just hit these. That. That. I'm joking, it's very simple.
Let's see how far this thing can shoot.
Wow, it shoots all the way across the room.
Let's see how far this thing can shoot outside.
So Hobby Pig is about 20 feet away. Let's see if he can reach us here with a dart. Oh, that was close. So I'd say roughly about 20 feet. Man, that was good. Why is he so upset? All right, here's our test to see if we can shoot Hobby Pig from here. He's about 18 paces away. Let's see if we can get him. Oh, wow, that thing shoots pretty good.
Let's go shoot some targets.
I'm hunting for targets. There's more targets coming.
Oh, you did that on purpose.
The Hobby family jumped inside the Hobby Kids TV helicopter and headed to the scavenger hunt.
It's a Target scavenger hunt. Let's go find some toys.
Will you help us find all the clues at Target? Make sure to leave your comments of your favorite aisle at Target.
Do you guys see the first clue? What does it say?
If you only have a dollar, you're in luck. The next clue is found where things cost a buck.
Where things cost a buck. So where do we go?
We go over there.
Okay, take me there.
I'm gonna put my shoes here.
Okay. Aw, look at the doggy up there. He looks so cute. Let's see if we can find our clue. This is where the $1 items are. You guys see any clues yet?
No.
First, let's see what's hiding inside this Dory case.
This is a special lunchbox because there's some surprises inside. Woo! I have a Lego Mario Fit blind bag. I really hope if we get a donut.
Shark guy. What do you have? Hobby Pig.
Batman.
Vinyl figures. How many different kinds can you collect?
83 billion.
Wow, those are all the different ones you can collect. Which one do you want?
I hope we get the golden Batman.
The golden Batman, that would be great.
Or Batman.
Hobby Bear, what did you get? Ooh, it's a Imaginex blind bag. Look at all the cool Imaginex figures you can get. I hope you get the one that looks like Godzilla. Hobby Frog, let's have you go first. Man, I hope you get the shark.
Alright, let's see what I got.
Oh, there's a head. Ooh. That looks interesting. Here's all the minifigs that you can collect for the Series 15 blind bags. They got some cool things going on. They've got like Pan right there, cool futuristic guy with an awesome sword, a wrestling David Bowie. How about it? An Indian with a baby. That is adorbs. The shark guy, I think everyone wants the shark guy because he's super cool. Oh, there's a guy who's like really beaten up. That is pretty funny. He has a cast on. That's awesome. Wow, and there it is. We got the princess. It took Hobby Frog a while to make. She's like one of the strangest minifigs I've ever seen.
Yeah.
She has a big dress. It takes up like the entire plate here.
A big.
Crazy. And she had like two pieces of material that make up her cape. So that's pretty neat. I don't think I've seen her hair before too. That's like a unique hairstyle for a minifig. Even the face, too. The silk screen I've never seen before. Hobby Bear, what did you get in there? Ooh, that's interesting. Oh, hey, you got the four-armed alien guy. That is super, super cool. I have never seen a figure with four arms in Imaginex before.
Are you kidding me? Wow, that's awesome. Wow.
He's like the first one on the bag. That means everyone wants him. How cool is that? Here's all the other figures that you can collect. And yeah, the Godzilla guy would be super cool. That guy, four arms, never seen before on Imaginex figure. Super cool. And he has three eyeballs, a super awesome smile. Oh yeah, let's put his little helmet thing on. That covers his awesome smile. See, right now you don't think he's a nice alien, but he is because he's smiling. Hobby Pig's got a cool vinyl figure box. Let's see what guy he got. Gold Batman.
Yeah! Oh, wait. Feel it.
Does it feel like Batman?
I didn't feel any pointy things.
That's an important thing to look for.
I just want to hope I get any type of Batman. Oh! What
we got?
What? Wonder Woman.
Oh, we got Wonder Woman! An exclusive GameStop figure that you can't get anywhere else, so that's kind of cool, right? Mm-hmm. Ooh, look, she's gonna beat some guy up. Or a girl. Or...
Hi-ya!
Oh, Wonder Woman. Be nice to Hobby Pig.
The hobby kids jumped into their jet and headed back to Target to find the next clue. Will you help us out?
He's wagging his tail. What does your clue say?
You read this one.
Where can we find Hobby Dad?
Ooh, where's Hobby Dad? Where would he be? Let's go find Hobby Dad. He always disappears in Target, and we always have to go and find him.
Yes. And I know which aisle he goes to every time he goes here. No, not there. Of course not. There he is.
You see him?
Of course.
Where?
He goes to the Pokemon aisle.
Pokemon aisle.
Oh, I need this. I don't have that.
We found him. And we found the clue.
I need more Pokemon cards.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
You have way too many.
What are you talking
here,
about?
Let me just take
this
clue.
Ah!
Before we read the next clue, let's check out these Pokemon cards that Hobby Dad loves so much.
Fates collide with Pokemon trading cards and the new awesome deck that we're gonna build. Are you excited, Hobby Pig?
Yeah!
You've been wanting a fighter deck for a while, and this is a good jump start because we're gonna build one with Zygarde. Am I saying that right? Zygarde. You ready to open this stuff up and see what good pulls we can get? Let's do it! So this is a deck that you can buy if you want to start playing. A lot of people have commented, how do you start playing Pokemon? Well, you buy a deck like this.
It shows the different type of Pokemon that you could get in a set on the side of the box.
So there's the coin you get with this deck. It's awesome. It's a Zygarde coin. You do need a coin to play Pokemon. And there are the damage counters, so that way you can keep track of the damage of each Pokemon, and also a burn marker or a poison marker, because that could happen to your Pokemon too. You never know. Ooh, and there's the battle mat. It comes with the up-to-date rules, as long as you get an up-to-date deck. And it shows you where you put all of your cards for two players. Just like a roadmap. Remember roadmaps before smartphones.
Now let's open this one up. Oh, look! It's a Pinpin!
Ooh, so sparkly shiny. Well, you like pin it on your hat if you're playing Pokemon so people know the Pokemon cards you've collected. It's kind of cool.
But let's open these packs up.
You know what? Yeah, just give me the pen.
The Zygarde collection. Opening that. They really know how to like put these things in a box. Can I eat this?
No, you can't eat it.
Why? It's gluten free. I think he's super awesome.
All right, so we're gonna get this deck ready for an awesome battle. Stay tuned for Hobby Kids TV for Hobby Dad versus Hobby Pig Pokemon card battle. Oh, I'm so gonna win.
The Hobby Kids jump inside their rocket ship back to the egg to find a surprise inside.
Welcome back from the Target scavenger hunt. Now let's see what's in this awesome surprise egg. Hobby Bear, what's inside? Oh, wow! It's Imaginex, Doomsday, and Superman. Let's get ready for an epic battle! Doomsday versus Superman. Oh man, this is such a great set because Doomsday and Superman duked it out and destroyed a whole city until they both got knocked out. Are you ready, Hobby Bear?
Yes!
Let's do it! No. Take a look at the back of the box. So you can use the power disc to activate his arms, and it also completes this wonderful set that you can also see on our playlist. Here we go. You always gotta follow the instructions when you're opening up Imaginex. Ah, the strings. No strings attached, except for these three. Oh, yeah.
Batman video bomb.
Man, that is super cool. Let's take a look at the minifig. Now, this must be the most upset and unhappy Superman I have ever seen as an Imaginext figure. Scrapes on his chest that are painted on, and his eyes are red, showing he's using his laser vision. His mouth is very unhappy. I'm a very grumpy Superman. Now let's just take a look at this Superman. They're the exact same figure, but he has a different silk screen on his face right here, and he doesn't have the tear marks on his suit. He has the material cape, which I like better because it doesn't like get in the way of his motion. And that is a great Superman minifig. Here you go, Hobby Bear. And as Hobby Bear showed us, when you put the figure up here, he goes onto a power disc. When you rotate it this way, it makes this arm go up. When you rotate it this way, it makes this arm go up. He is actually a very strange size toy for Imaginext. Let's take a look at some other scaled figures that are about the same size, just so you can see how big this Doomsday character really is. Let's compare Doomsday to Gorilla Grodd. Wow, he's a lot bigger than Gorilla Grodd. Actually makes him look kind of small. But as you can see, Gorilla Grodd's pretty big. Who else? Hey, how about Clayface? Clayface is pretty big. Here's Clayface. Wow, he's still a lot taller than Clayface even. Ooh, I know. Let's use Solomon Grundy, born on a Sunday. Wow, Doomsday is the biggest character figure that Imaginext has made so far that I can tell. Now let's get a little ridiculous and try Lex Luthor's. Wow, even Lex Luthor's mech is not as big. What about Mr. Freeze's robot? Oh, that's close. That's close, but I still think, well, they might be the same height, but this isn't a character. He's a character, so he is super awesome because he is so far the biggest Imaginext character I have seen. Really cool detail on the back.
This is the same green suit in the comic books when Doomsday broke out of prison.
Every time there was a layer of this prison suit torn off of him, his bones and armor grew bigger and meaner. This character comes with this bent girder. Let's see if we can fit it into his hands and make it useful. Hey, that's cool. This thing is molded in such a way where it actually fits his hand, so it looks like he's crushing this steel girder, which shows he's super strong. Now let's see if he can lift it. Oh yeah, he's gonna bat around some Batman and Superman guys for sure. Hey Superman, can you help us out? Sure! Oh, thanks. Okay, Doomsday, hit him on top of the head with that.
Wait a minute, what?
There we go. Hey, that hurt, Doomsday. I've defeated you once and I can defeat you again. Take this! Ow! Oh yeah, you're like super strong. Now, Doomsday kind of reminds me of the Hulk. He has super Hulk-like strength and he could jump really far and high. And the more he gets beaten up, the more these bone-like armor plates stick out of his body, making him one tough guy to take down. Superman did it, but boy, did he get beat up too. It went a little something like this. Through their final punches, they both connected. Oh, and knocked each other out.
Hey, Superman! Bro-tato chip. It's me, Batman.
Oh, where you go? Come on, it's me, Ben Affleck. I'm here to beat you up for some weird reason. Oh, hey, Ooh. Looks like someone already took care of that for me. Oh, I looked at on that one.
The Hobby family jumped inside their special submarine to find the next clue at Target.
It says, your dog is hungry. Where do you go? The next clue, you will know.
I know where we go.
Where do you go when your dog is hungry? Where do you go?
The pet food aisle.
Ooh, let's try that.
Let's go.
That
is
pretty cool.
All
right, so those are the stuff that we got.
That is
that.
A pretty cool Pokemon.
What?
Wow.
Charizard.
Really?
I got a problem.
Size.
Oh, they're so cute. I just want to squish them. Squish, 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 squish.
Hey, Hobby Frog, what do we have here? They are superhero mashers, but they're like tiny and super cool.
They're mini mashers.
Mini mashers. How awesome is that? How about we open these things up and have some fun?
But I don't have arms. I'm a head on the ground.
Well, just use your teeth and chew them out. Just kidding. So you're gonna open that one, I'll open this one. Oh boy.
We can mix these three together.
Oh, I love the smell of new plasticky toys. Ooh.
I like the new smell of new toys.
Here's all the other cool characters you can get. And they also have vehicles that can match and mix too, I'm assuming. Probably. So here's Spider-Man. Let's put on his arm right here.
Does he move his legs?
Actually, he's not that movie. He doesn't move at all. He just can change out his arms and his head. Ooh. He has this really cool Spider-Man backpack that fits on the back. That's awesome. Kind of looks like Dr. Octopus.
Oh, guys, look. Hulk has a giant fist.
Oh, cool.
Let's put it on him right now. See what it looks like with it.
That is an awesome giant fist, man. Wow. Can you imagine him trying to knock on your door? Wow, look, it looks like he has a giant eyeball. Like he's really angry. Oh, ow. You just hit me with Loki's staff. That's actually a cool staff. Here you go. Whoop.
Thank you.
Man, that fist. I'm still like so excited about this fist. Look at this.
It's just that was Loki.
What, the fist?
Mm-hmm.
It's a good idea. Oh, what a good test. Oh. Hey, how does it work? Does it work on Spider-Man? Oh. Hey, let's give Spider-Man that huge fist.
Spider-Man. But after we do Spider-Man, we'll do Loki next.
Actually, Loki might kind of match because he's kind of green too. Here is Loki, always smiling devilishly because he's concocting some plan for world domination. He has his ginormous horns, and you can take off his cape. So you can give your cape to another person, which is kind of cool. And this, maybe we should stick it on his arm. There we go. That's better? Yeah. Okay. And wouldn't it be cool if Hulk was a Jedi Knight? Look at this. You can use pieces from your other mash 'em guys, and you can use them on the little guys. Isn't that great?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's totally a Jedi Knight now. Wouldn't it be cool if Spider-Man wore Boba Fett's helmet? Yeah, Spider-Man never looked better. Ah! Oh, it's Hulk with his kind of primitive mind in the body of Loki. Not too impressive. But on the other end, if you have Loki that has a very clever mind, and he's a bad guy, and he has Hulk's strength, that's pretty intimidating. That's something you don't want to run into. And he has Spider-Man's backpack. Wow, that's something else. Uh-oh, but at least Spider-Man has a giant fist. Oh! Knocked him out of the park. Oh, and he's shooting webs at him. Yeah, you still win, Spider-Man. And that's why good guys always win.
Woo! And his head's gone.
Oh, his head. Aw. Oh, now it's just a Hulk bod. A nice Hulk bod. Except it's green.
Do I have two heads or what?
Yeah, that head is too, hey, look at me. Hey, look at Hulk. He's taking a nap. Not a good time to lose your head. And there is Spider-Man with the Hulk arm and the cool cape of Loki. That looks really good. I'm digging that. Wow. When you do that, it makes him look super cool. Like he's in a tornado. Oh! Oh, wow. He has Hulk head for a hand and a Loki head for a hand. That means he can't pick up anything gross because he'd probably taste it. Yeah. Gross. I wonder if they have good conversations, though. Probably. Well, not Hulk so much.
Next, we loaded into the Hobby Kid tractor and went back to the giant surprise egg.
Welcome back from the Target scavenger hunt. Oh, we've got a hobby frog. And I think he's looking for a toy. Which one will he find?
Did the egg lay an egg? Oh, he's going to check to see.
Oh, I think he found something. Oh, the egg is pooping out a surprise. Is there an Olympic medal for frog jumping? There should be. He'd win the medal. Wow! Jungle Quest! These things are so cool, because they're really awesome to play with, and you can bring them anywhere you want to go to have a good time. Woo! Woo! Hey! It's Thomas and Friends Take and Play! These are my favorite types of trains, because you can pretty much take them anywhere. That's awesome! Greetings from the jungle. Thomas the Train comes with his own Thomas the Train. Die-cast metal. Ooh, solid. Get it solid. Ooh, it lifts up to the second level. Can't wait to get this opened up and have some fun.
I have a box body.
Oh, hey, Mr. Box Body. We're gonna open you up. And it looks like it has a cool ape skull that chomps on trains. Let's open up and have some fun! Woo! Let's look at the back of the box. Fisher Price, ages 3 and up. And wow, this thing looks like it's gonna, hey, there's Mr. Topham Hat. Hello, Mr. Topham Hat. He's not a bad guy. He's the train conductor, not conductor. He like owns the train. I don't know what he is, but he's cool. So there's some assembly required. Yeah, definitely. Assembly. So if you decide to buy this, just be prepared for adult assembly required. These are the instructions. Look at that. There's 23 steps. And yeah, we're going to get on this. And Hobby Frog, would you like to put together? Let's do it. Here it is, all put together. Good job, Hobby Frog. That is a really cool train set. Let's see how it works. It all starts with here. Which cart does Thomas want to ride on? Which one, that one first? All right, let's do that one first. And if the flags aren't down, there's red flags here. If they're not down, you can go to the other side. But we don't want them to go to the other side. We want to put the flags down. We're going to go on the ride on the jungle elevator.
Take him for a ride, Hobby Frog. Uh-oh. Here it comes. Uh-oh.
Let's take a ride on the other one, see what that does. Oh no, he's gonna go through the gorilla's mouth. Woo! Now we're gonna see if this cart is gonna meet up with Thomas after he goes on the elevator. Let's give it a try. Oh, didn't quite make it. You could put the cart. The cart's really cool because it shows it has diamonds in the cart. Or you could flip it over and you can't see what's in there. Diamonds? No diamonds. There's a little place right here. It shows a small cart picture and you could put it there for safekeeping. There's also one for Thomas. It has a picture of a train engine and you could snap them in. Those aren't going anywhere. And take it to a friend's house or put it in your closet.
We then got into our hobby spaceship and went back to Target for the next clue.
When you are hot, you need to cool down. This cold treat.
I am squishy and soft. You hug me at night. Is where the next clue is in your sight. So what is squishy and soft?
A pillow.
And you hug me at night. Pillow, you guys wanna go check the pillow aisle? Uh-huh. All right, let's head out. Let's go.
Alex, I see it. The pillows are right there.
There's the pillows. Do you see any clues? This is kind of fun. There's pillows down here. Did I see anything down there?
I think I see something. Right there.
Hobby Frog, do you see anything?
Right there.
Jump out, get it. Oh.
Oh, the next.
What did we get? Air hogs. Air wing blaster. That's gonna be fun. Let's put this in our cart and buy it.
Yay! Blaster.
From Air Hogs. This thing shoots way up in the sky and sprouts wings and flies. Let's see what it does. Well, gotta take it out of the box. And it looks like there's some assembly required.
All right, now can it fly?
Oh, better than it did last time. You're gonna pick that up, right? Hey, you come back here. So the actual rocket itself is all the way assembled, which is good. I was kind of worried about that part. And then there's the air hose. It's already attached to the launching tube, which is good. All you have to really put together is the stand, and that's not too bad. And then you got this really big air tank that fits here. That's gonna shoot really far.
I can go underwater now.
No, do not go underwater with that air tank. Wrong type of air tank. Sorry, buddy. All right, let's put this together. So we've got the air squish tank set up right here, and the hose goes around to the launcher, and we've got the rocket hooked up right here. Now, it's like on a spring. So it shoots the wings out, but you have to tuck the wings into this little tray right here.
Ah.
So they don't go anywhere. But the instructions also say that you have to pull the wings out like this for a successful launch. Are you ready, Hobby Pig?
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna back up and see how this thing flies. Go for it! Whoa! The wings did not engage. Here we go. Whoa! Whoa! Ah, failed lunch.
Oh, did it fly?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Let's see if this thing can be shot forward.
Wonder what flies like if you just hold it like this and throw it. Nope.
Oh, day, aren't you?
Hey, that was cool. That was cool.
I wonder what happens if you start to push it and drop it.
It's so easy, even Hobby Bear likes it. Boom!
Oh. Hey, let's parachute out of this place and get back to that giant Target surprise egg.
Hobby Pig is looking for another surprise. Ooh, that looks cool. Oh, wow, let's go fishing, XL. Hey, look, it's only a Target.
Cool. I wanna go fishing!
Let's go fishing, deep sea edition. Are you ready to help us?
Yes.
Oh, look, we even have worms. Just kidding, we're not gonna use worms. Yeah. That would be weird, huh, Superman?
Look at me.
While Hobby Dad and Hobby Pig are actually fishing, Hobby Frog and Hobby Bear are going to be playing the fishing game. XL. Who's going to catch the most fish? You guys ready to play? Here we go. Did you pull one out? Are you a little cheater, pumpkin eater?
Oh!
I got one.
Ah!
Cool. I got one too.
You got one too?
Yeah.
No way! That's so cool.
Oh, we're doing good, and I got a shell.
Hey, good job.
I got one.
You got one?
Yeah. Got one.
Oh, he's just gonna pick him out. He's giving up. All right, go. Who's who can pick out the most? Quick, hurry.
One.
Okay, that's not counting.
So it all got mixed up.
We decided to head back to shore to find the next clue at Target.
When you are hot, you need to cool down. This cold treat will the clue be found.
I see.
You little stinkers. How do you know this?
I see.
Strawberry lemonade. Awesome.
delicious. Mm. You like it?
Yes.
What color is it?
Blue ice.
It's blue ice, huh?
Yeah.
Is it delicious, Hobby Dad?
It was very good.
Mm. How about you, Hobby Frog? Yeah. Yummy. Can I have a bite?
Sure.
That's good. Can I have a bite, Hobby Bear? Can you give Mommy a bite?
The Hobby Kids jumped into the Hobby Kid bus, turned on YouTube, and watched
Hobby Kids.